New Jersey 101.5. Our own radio station. Not New York. Not Philadelphia. Proud to be New Jersey.
New Jersey 101.5.
New Jersey Chime Time is 8:09. Steve Trevelise. We were talking about this in the last hour. A ninth grader at John F. Kennedy High School in Paterson arrested, charged with assaulting a teacher in a classroom. What did he do? The teacher, physics class, confiscates the cell phone, which belonged to the ninth grader's friend. So the ninth grader naturally sneaks up behind him, wraps his arms around him, throws him around the room, throws him over a desk, takes the cell phone. And the teacher, who can't defend himself, he's not allowed to, just has to stand there and let him do it. I want to get your thoughts on that and also on the upcoming PARC tests that are going to happen in March. You know the story with those. You got teachers teaching to the test and not to the class. And when topics of education come up, I like to bring in my expert on all things educated. He's been named one of the most influential educators in America. He's People Magazine's Sexiest Teacher Alive. He's Men's Fitness 25 Fittest Men. And he's also awake at 8:10. Nick Ferroni from Union High School. Hey, pal.
How you doing, Steve?
I'm good. Now, you told me you showed the video to your class at Union High School. What was their reaction?
I just showed them the clip just to hear their opinion. And again, it's an issue that all schools deal with, even our school, as far as how to deal with technology and cell phones. And I was curious to get their feedback as well, just to see if they thought the teacher should have took it or what their opinion was and what they felt about the student's response or reaction to the situation. And most of my students, I mean, as well as myself, felt that the student was obviously completely out of hand in that issue. And it's funny because many people always argue, well, he shouldn't click the phone. But then that's defending the behavior and also saying basically that students can do anything in class.
Why are cell phones allowed in class?
Well, I use cell phones as a teaching tool in a very effective way. It can be very useful in the classroom. Now, again, schools that don't have iPads, cell phone can serve the same purpose. I mean, for the most part, we don't allow them in class or school unless they're used for that very reason, which a lot of teachers do use them for in class.
Okay. Now, in this situation, the teacher's not allowed to defend himself. I mean, what would you do if a student, you know, came up, or you took a cell phone, and the kid decided he wanted to grab you and throw you around the room? Strong as you are, you can't defend yourself.
And that does put you in a tough situation as a teacher, because no matter what you do, they'll consider it excessive force.
Right.
And especially, so it is, I mean, teachers are very defenseless on certain issues like that. I mean, my argument even proposed to my students, and my students said it, and I don't know if that's because I teach them to be proactive. They said, well, why didn't any of his classmates help him out? Like, help out the teacher, or at least stop the friend from doing it, which it's one of those tough situations. I also want to point out, too, that a lot of the comments, that is not the representation of public school. No, I feel the need to defend my students and many students because not every student reacts that way. It was a very small, it's a minor case in the overall spectrum of things. I mean, and my other argument is I would like to see what other deeper issues that student has that they feel the need to react that way. I mean, to me, a teenager is a teenager.
Right.
Whether it was a criminal act, there has to be a greater reason why that student felt the need to do that, stemming for a larger issue.
But regardless of that reason, you still don't get the right to do that. You know, and why weren't those kids involved?
I mean, you do hear kids yelling out, somebody do something. Unfortunately, no one does something. And that's the unfortunate issue. I mean, I'd like to think in another situation that kids would break it up and do the right thing. But, to me, it's unexcusable. I do not want the kids, I don't think the kids' life should be over, but it has to be made example, because if there's no punishment, then it just gives the message that students can do whatever they want in the classroom.
What kind of a punishment would you give them?
There has to be some extensive suspension, at least until you get the student evaluated. Because as a parent, too, I wouldn't want that student sitting next to my child knowing that they can react that way in any situation.
No.
I mean, I think it's on behalf of the other parents, too, to stand up for the school saying, you know, we want to be certain that this child's not a threat to himself or any of his classmates before he enters that building again or to another teacher.
No, that's a great point. Now, on to the other thing I want to talk to you about, the PARC tests that are coming up. we've talked about this before when you and I, you know, when you came in on my show when I was filling in for the Minsky and Doyle. Commissioner Hespe, David Hespe, was going to come on this program on Thursday night with Eric Scott and talk about, you know, there's going to be a town hall series. And after saying he would be here, decided not to come because a point-counterpoint debate on park tests would be inappropriate. Now, how do you feel about that? I know, right? How do you feel about the park test? And should Hespe be here?
Well, he should be there. And I feel like he's not there because the sheer fact that there's no evidence supporting the park test. And it's usually what happens. It's like in court. You know, you ask someone to commit a crime, I plead the fifth, which basically says I'm guilty, but at the same time, they're not admitting it. Mm-hmm. It's one of those interesting things. I mean, again, the park test on a national level is so many states are opting out, and there's no merit. And to me, it's destructive to education. It's intentionally setting teachers and students up for failure. And my argument is, the irony is it was basically pushed through by Bill Gates, mm-hmm. which contradicts the way that he grew up and his learning style. This guy was a kinesthetic learner. He cut school to go and mess around and break down computers and play around with that. I would be curious. I think it's only fair that we ask people like Bill Gates, like the Department of Head Chair, and even Chris Christie to take the park test. Let's see how they do. They're successful. Let's see how they would do on the actual park test, since we're going to force it upon students.
Now, what's it going to be like for you having to teach this again in March and May?
Well, but again, that's the irony, because teachers, they always joke that people can't do teach. When in fact, if you could manage a classroom and you could teach in a school for a school year, I guarantee you put any one of us in any managerial position and we will make it work. So teachers will find a way to make it work. The irony is, it's like me telling you that I'm going to prepare you for a marathon. Mm-hmm. So you train for the first 6 months for a marathon, and all of a sudden I test you on football skills. So it's like now, and you're going to be like, well, that wasn't a marathon. Well, don't worry, you got to do it. So we're basically...
Too bad.
Yeah, too bad. But that's what they're doing. They're telling us to do one thing, and then they're evaluating us on another, which is so unfair. And it's not only fair to teachers, but it's unfair to students. I mean, I can't imagine how kids are going to deal with this. And we've been through the process of taking workshops on a park test. And I can't, as an educator, I can't comprehend how I would do it, let alone a teenager or a student who's been going down one road and now completely forced to down another. And it's unfortunately, but to schools, we have to do it. Because our Department of Ed is telling us to.
Now, I don't envy you at all. And on top of that, you know, part of your performance gets evaluated on it.
But to me, it's wasting. And the irony is everyone knows it's not right for schools. Yet to me and to most teachers, we're wasting a year of a kid's education. And in 4 years, 1 year, that is so significant for them to be an experiment for some people who have power and money and who believe they know what's best for education. And we can't experiment with kids' lives every 2 years. It's destructive.
No, you're absolutely right. Hey, man, thanks so much for coming on. Hey, go see The Imitation Game. You'll love it.
I will definitely go see it. And hopefully I'll be in anytime you want me to come down there. I love to be sitting across from you and chime in anytime you want. So thank you very much.
You got it, pal. That's Nick Ferroni, Union High School teacher. Now, we're talking about, he said some great things about the park test. I want to get your thoughts on the park test, because as a teacher, you're wasting the students' time. Commissioner Hespe doesn't want to waste his time being in on a town hall series talking to you because he thinks it would be a waste of time. He thinks it would be inappropriate. Also inappropriate is when a ninth grader decides to throw a teacher around the room because he confiscated his cell phone.